morning. Good morning, eighth grade. It's good to see you all. First of all, welcome to everyone that's here today. This is always a great time of year. I think day after day, over the last couple weeks, we've been celebrating our students throughout our school district in a lot of different ways. So this is a really exciting today here for us here at STEM, as we celebrate this great, great, great group of eighth graders. So I want to first start by thanking and congratulating this group of parents and families. Yes. This is the truth. This group of eighth grade parents and families, I believe, has been the best group of eighth grade parents and families that we have had here at STEM. Always, whenever we have called, whenever we have reached out, whenever we have had events, you all have been here. Chaperoning field trips, parent-teacher conferences, any type of event that we've had, you all have shown up to support us and support our students. So I really, really appreciate that. I know our eighth grade team appreciates that, and our eighth graders, our students appreciate that. And it's, you know, it hasn't always been easy. Not all the conversations have been fun conversations, but we really appreciate your support. I think that everyone in this room, we want what's best for these young people right here, and it shows. It shows. So thank you. Yes. And I'd also really like to thank our middle school team, led by Ms. Labrum, obviously, as well as Ms. Skelly, our math teacher, Mr. Jordan, Ms. Udihaj, Ms. Lichtenwalder, Ms. Jones-Lohman, Mr. Bortz, and Mr. Bernie. We just have a great group of teachers. Our eighth graders are clapping for them right now because they know. We have a great team for our eighth graders. So this will be the last time that I speak to you all as a group. I love coming in saying good morning, eighth grade, when I see you all in the morning. I'm gonna really miss your class. I'm not gonna be your principal next year, but I will still know what you're doing in the classroom and what you're doing outside the classroom. Believe that. I will be checking up on you and making sure that you know you're continuing to do the right thing. So I'm going to leave you with a very short message. It's going to be very short, but you need to remember it. You need to remember this message, okay? You're going to start in September with a clean slate, fresh start for all of you. Whether you're still here at STEM or whether you're going to school somewhere else, you will have a clean slate. Regardless of how this year went, last year, all the years before, you'll start fresh next year. However, next year will be the last fresh start that you'll have. Because once you're in ninth grade, everything that you do in the classroom and outside the classroom will be on your transcript. You'll be building towards your senior year when you start applying to colleges and start deciding what happens next. Okay? There's no more fresh starts after that. So what I want you to remember through this summertime and when you walk back into school in September is that everything that you do from September in ninth grade on through ninth grade and 10th grade and 11th grade and 12th grade, everything that you do will stay with you and matters. Okay? Everybody got that? We good? Okay. So I just want to leave you with this. I'm very, very, very excited and appreciative of what you brought to our school for the last year or the last 2 years. And I want you to know that when I see you next year and the year after and the year after and the year after, I'm gonna ask you about this little message that I gave you this morning. So when I say, what did we talk about at eighth grade graduation? I want you to be able to tell me exactly what we talked about, and I want you to show me that you understood it by what you do next year and beyond. All right, eighth grade? Thank you very much.
All The vocalist is not yet here, so we're going to go ahead and present our awards, our individual class awards. I'm Julie Labrum. I'm the English teacher. I've had a lot of these kids for 7th and 8th grade. I want to thank the parents for their support over the past 2 years. You don't even know how much of a difference it makes to have supportive parents. But I also want to thank the kids, because I know I yell at you all the time, but also because I love you and I've had you for 2 years, I kind of feel like you belong to me and I can yell at you and tell you the truth about things. So never in complete anger, but because I want you to be the best version of yourselves. And we're preparing you to be the adults that you're going to be. You make me laugh with all the funny things you say, the funny things you do, your dances. Just keep me occupied and entertained all the time. And each one of you are special to me. I think you know that, but I just wanted to say it. As you go forward in life, remember the words that Steve Jobs once said, and he invented the iPhone, so you know he knows what he's talking about. He said, "Your time is limited, so don't waste it living someone else's life. Don't let the noise of others' opinions drown out your own inner voice, and most importantly, have the courage to follow your heart and your intuition." When I was looking at your career projects, I can see all the things that you aspire to be in your life. So I want you to know that in the blink of an eye, high school will be over and you'll be on your way. But until then, make good choices. Do what's right, and you can't go wrong if you do those things. So keep that in mind. For my class, awards. It's hard because we have so many great kids, but you have to hone it down to a couple. Let me just grab one. Okay, so for my first award, this person I've had for 2 years, both of these people have an internal motivation to want to understand what they're doing, what they need to do, and to complete the task. Internal motivation is something that they don't get from somebody else. It comes from inside them, and that's going to take them far in life. This first person is thorough in everything she does. She's insightful. She has interesting ways of looking at things. And she's very diligent. So she might work slowly because she is those things, but she's diligent and gets everything done. And she keeps on top of things. So for that reason, and many more, Kyla Grasty.
Girl, when you dance, there's a magic that must be love. Just take it slow. You got so far to go. When you feel that heat, and we gonna ride the boogie. Share that beat of love. I wanna ride with you.
The next person has really come out of his shell this year. This person has a great sense of humor, has kept me entertained every single week for 2 years with entertaining. So every week we have a vocab quiz, and from all the words we've learned that week, you have to use 3 of them in a sentence. And it doesn't have to be three words in one sentence. It can just be three separate sentences. But this person goes the extra mile and writes me a literal short story every week that are hilarious, that always keep me entertained. And this person is also exceedingly conscientious, always gets all their work done, and to a very high standard. So for that reason, my award goes to Jahlil Carter. Extra awards to give out because we do a thing, and I'm sure you've heard about it. It's called Reading Plus, right? But some people have slayed it this year, and I'm going to give them a little extra shout out because it's a lot, and they did a lot, and they were very diligently working at it. So, these are the people who have leveled up more than anyone else. And for those of you who know anything about Reading Plus, it takes a lot to level up. So the fact that they did it six or more times is really astounding. So my first one goes to Zakira Day. And this person, same thing, working like an animal on the Reading Plus. Leveled up so many times, it's ridiculous. Mr. Mike Sapatanga. Thank you very much.
Good morning. Most of you know me as Miss Heffelfinger. I am officially Mrs. Skelly now. I just wanted to say thank you for an awesome first year here at STEM. You guys all were super supportive and welcoming, and the kids worked really hard. We definitely had some struggles. We all know math is not everybody's favorite subject. I don't take it personally. But we had some really, really hardworking kids this year, and I think that they learned a lot. They pushed themselves. They just worked really hard. So thank you to the students. Thank you to the parents for always being supportive and being there to make sure they're doing their iReady and turning in their work. So the awards for math this year, again, just like Ms. Labrum said, it was really hard to narrow it down to two. But both of these individuals worked tirelessly all year to have straight A's, always turned in their work on time, always, you know, helped out fellow classmates if they needed support. So the first award goes to our Challenge 24 winner who represented our school both here and at the county, Mr. Mike Sapatanga. Always turned in her work on time, had straight A's all year, and also had the absolute most growth I've seen out of anyone on iReady, made it to a 10th grade level, Miss Valkeisha.
I'm Miss Udi Hodge, I teach science. So I just wanted to first thank all the students for a very memorable year. I've seen you all work very hard to understand some complex topics and ask a lot of really good questions. Today I wanted to celebrate two students who have consistently shown a genuine interest in science and come to class every single day, ready to learn and ready to give their best effort and step up to the plate even when it isn't for a grade. So for my first student, for her wonderful work in creating a data-driven science fair project and her great understanding of a wide range of scientific topics, I'd like to give this award to Latai Jordan. I just want to say thank you for all you've done this year, Latai, to represent STEM Academy in a positive light, especially at the Science Fair. Okay. So my next person is awarded for partially for his love and knowledge of animals, but also for a consistent effort. This person comes to class every single day with something positive to contribute to their peers and has even taught me a thing or two about animal species. So thank you for constantly encouraging those around you to be their best selves. I'm going to award this to Timothy for Okay, I just want to say a quick thank you to all the students who have made this year memorable. We all know that school is about a lot more than just schoolwork. So I wanted to acknowledge all the students who have worked hard to make our classroom environment a happier, safer, and nicer place. I hope that as you transition into high school, you carry what it means to be a scientist. So continue to think critically and analytically in response to information you're given. Good luck.
How are you guys doing this morning? My name is Mr. Jordan. So this is my second year here, and a lot to what Mrs. Labrum and Mr. Bell were saying. This is a special group. You know, this is the first group I've had 2 years in a row. So, I mean, next year when you guys are in high school, please, you know, come down. My door's always open. You need help with something. I'd love to be there for you guys in that way, help you out. But here at STEM, we know that acronym stands for Science, Technology, Engineering, and Mathematics. So one of the first awards I want to give out is our Citizenship Award. And there's another acronym here at STEM that we use. It's Show Respect, Engagement, or Take Accountability, Engagement, and Mindfulness. Sorry, I did write it down, but. So these awards go to those people. You know, I can always count on them for being a beacon in the hallways. Sometimes, you know, I get labeled the hall monitor from middle school or the fake security guard. So it's always nice having a couple students that could help me out on that front. And first one is to Siani Forner. This next award I want to give out to a young man, you know, who definitely shows respect. I can always count on him. You know, he's always, you know, asking me how I'm doing, seeing if other people need anything. And this young man is going to be Vanel Melendez. also teach social studies. And so I have a couple of awards for people in the classroom that excelled very well. You know, these two students had an A in my class. They were participating. They were people I could count on. And I just wanted to take a moment to recognize their efforts in the classroom. And first one I'm going to present is to Kiana Casimir. Award to do today, and then we could get started with the procession and eat some cake. So the last student I wanted to recognize is Zane Thomas.
One time. What you've looked forward to ever since you walked through the doors at STEM, it's happening. Here are our promotion candidates. Mr. Bell is going to present the certificates. The first person is Milan Battle. Jalil Carter. Kiana Casimir. Chloe Danner. Kayla Davis Clark. Zakira Day. Quasir Evans. Siani Fournier. Famad Gibson. Karina Gale. Kyla Grasty. De'Asia Harper. Trace L. Hill. Latai Jordan. Darnasia Long.
I want to sing this.
Joshua McDowell. Vanel Melendez. Fanalise Melendez. Sydney Miles. Josiah Muhammad Jones.
Bring the beat in.
Neasia Naylor. Sanika Alba. Jayla Red. Aisha Spence. Karan Starkey. Jasmine Thomas.
Eighth grade. You guys ready for high school? We can start over eighth grade next year. Who wants to start over eighth grade next year? Okay. Awesome. It's obviously a very special day. Graduation is a time to look back on all we've accomplished and set our sights even higher for the future. Let's make a promise to ourselves right now to never give up on our dreams, no matter how big or how small. Okay, eighth grade may be ending, but there are so many great things ahead of us. I can't wait to see what the future holds for each and every one of you. And congratulations and best of luck to all of you. God bless. Okay, in closing, parents, we have cake and refreshments in the back. And we'd ask that you partake in those. And eighth grade, again, wish you all the best of luck. And I'll be seeing you around, okay? Have an awesome summer.